Hi, I am Dr. Saqib Mansoor, and I am speaking to you from my channel Learning Anatomy. And today I will discuss with you the clinicals of the hypothalamus. As you know, I am running with you the series of the lectures on the hypothalamus, and this is the fourth and the last with the clinicals. And so the results of lesions of the nuclei of the hypothalamus. First of all, the lesion of the lateral hypothalamic nuclei leads to starvation. You see, this is the starvation picture, right? Lesion of the lateral hypothalamic nuclei. And then lesion of the ventromedial nucleus causes polyphagia, obesity, and savage behavior. Yeah, you see, this is the, polyphagia, excessive eating. And this is obesity. Patient with obesity, the body mass index, BMI, is markedly increased, right? And this is the savage behavior, or the person in rage. And the lesion of the anterior region results in hyperthermia, that is increase in core body temperature, that is more than 37 degrees Celsius. Lesion of the posterior region results in poikilothermia. This is inability to thermoregulate, poikilothermia. Thermoregulation means to maintain a body temperature to a normal level, whatever is the external temperature. Lesion of the preoptic area, if it is before puberty, it causes arrested sexual development. And if it is after puberty, it leads to amenorrhea in females or impotence in males. And lesion of dorsomedial nucleus causes savage behavior. This is a savage behavior, should already. So the next disease which results from the lesion of the hypothalamic nuclei is diabetes insipidus, DI, which has various types and with different causes. But here we will discuss one related with the hypothalamus, which is known as a central DI, or the central diabetes insipidus. It is due to lesion of the supraoptic and paraventricular nuclei of hypothalamus, which synthesize ADH. That is, ADH means antidiuretic hormone and oxytocin. Diabetes insipidus is characterized by polyuria and polydipsia. Polyuria is excessive production of urine, and polydipsia is the excessive thirst, results from lesion of the ADH pathways to the posterior lobe of the pituitary gland. Then next clinical resulting from the lesion of the hypothalamus is the syndrome of inappropriate ADH secretion, which is also known as SIADH. Here ADH is secreted in excessive amounts. It may be caused by lung tumors or drug therapy, for example, carbamazepine, chlorpromazine, and results in renal water retention and volume expansion for body fluids with consequent dilutional hyponatremia. Then the next disease is craniopharyngioma, which is, it is a congenital epidermoid tumor thought to originate from remnants of Wernicke pouch, usually calcified, the most common supratentorial tumor found in children. And pressure on the chiasm results in bitemporal hemianopia. This is the optic chiasma. So involvement of the hypothalamus in craniopharyngioma, this pressure on the hypothalamus causes hypothalamic syndrome. Of course, in hypothalamic syndrome, various nuclei would be involved, and it will be resulting in adiposity. There is the obesity and the diabetes insipidus, as I told you already, and the disturbances of the temperature regulation, I already told you, and somnolence. Somnolence is excessive sleep. Pituitary adenoma, the next disease, constitutes 50% of cases of clinically symptomatic intracranial tumors, seen seldom in children. Pressure on the chiasm results in bitemporal hemianopia. Most cases show asymmetry of field defects. And the hypothalamus, how it is involved, the pressure on the hypothalamus may cause hypothalamic syndrome, as I discussed the features of the hypothalamus with you in this slide, the craniopharyngioma. This is the hypothalamic syndrome, various features. Next disease resulting from the lesion of the nuclei of the hypothalamus is the Wernicke encephalopathy. This occurs due to lesions found primarily in the mammillary bodies and in the periaqueductal gray matter of the midbrain. Results from thiamine or the vitamin B1 deficiency characterized by the triad, these three things: ocular palsies, number two, intoxicate, and number three, mental confusion. Some other clinicals, lesions, they may cause sleep disturbance, for example, excessive sleep, somnolence, or the insomnia, the loss of sleep, and the emotional disorders, for example, depression or mania. Thank you very much for listening to this brief discussion on hypothalamus that completes the hypothalamus discussion. And I request you to support my channel and encourage me by subscribing and liking and commenting down below and sharing my lecture. Thank you very much. We'll now start a discussion on thalamus.